at the national level exercise, and for folks in the room, I'm sure you're aware that we have a congressionally mandated Tier 1 exercise program in this country that tests our preparedness and resiliency against a set of planning scenarios, 15 planning scenarios. And it's a heavily engaged effort. And until very recently, the private sector, as we understand it, has had a challenge in having a seat at the table in the design, planning, and execution of the national level exercises. In recent time, that has changed and changed dramatically. This FEMA administrator is committed to the relationship, the secretary is committed to the relationship, and folks have stepped up to where we now have a collaborative approach to how we're going to work to test our nation's preparedness and resiliency in a way different than we ever have. So we are now working aggressively to plan for the National Level Exercise 2011 that will test against a catastrophic earthquake event in the New Madrid seismic zone of the United States, involving 4 FEMA regions, 8 states, and obviously a broader stakeholder constituency that we probably don't even fully understand at this point. But we are inviting people to get involved. There are levels of participation that are available from full player all the way down to observer. And for many businesses and organizations that may just want to test their own emergency preparedness and business continuity capabilities, we can facilitate that as part of the process as well. I have been one over time, and some people in this room that have worked with me know that I have experienced some frustration around what I believe was not the level of collaboration that was possible. Today I sit here very excited and enthusiastic about a different attitude, a different approach, and a true communication, coordination, and collaboration in how we work together to test realistic scenarios, to identify the gaps, to build improvement plans, and to make this nation safer and more secure through the National Exercise Program.
Drop, cover, and hold on. That is the theme for what's being called the largest earthquake drill in American history. And a St. Louis public school was part of the multi-state drill. News Channel 5 education reporter Sharon Stevens is live outside of Carnahan High School of the Future in South St. Louis. Sharon?
Well, Lisa, they have been talking about earthquakes and drills throughout the city public school system. Today, the students at Carnahan got to carry out their lessons. They were part of an estimated 3 million participants in 11 states. At the signal, the 20 students in Lucy Duffy's class dropped to the floor, covered their heads, and held on to table legs. U.S. Education Secretary Arne Duncan and Homeland Security Secretary Janet Napoleano made a special visit to St. Louis to watch the drill.
So very, very impressed with the drill. We had almost 3 million school students and others participate in this just now across the country. But you've got the lead, so that should feel pretty good.
And if we don't prepare, really bad things happen.